everyone, welcome to June Empties. I don't have a huge amount, but I'm pretty proud of some of the things. So let's jump in, starting with hair products. This Paul Mitchell sculpting foam, I bought a whole bunch of things from a girlfriend who was going out of business with her hair salon. This was one of them. It was just okay. It didn't have enough stiffness for me in how it was dispensed and how it oomphed my hair up. My favorite is this Tresemme 4 Mousse. Now this is the very first one I've ever had that kind of fizzed out. Something is the matter, I've run hot water. If any of you have any suggestions, otherwise I will be calling this empty, but I love it. I've never had one do that before. Suave Moroccan conditioner. Several of you, because I said I had a hard time finding this, recommended the one that's in pink. And I'm using that now and I love it, so thank you. And then I did a video on how I color and style my hair. I'll link it somewhere. And it's always colored with the Revlon 04. I use half to three quarters of this depending on how blonde I want to go. More in the summer, obviously. And then I do another blonde, like 80s or 70s of the Revlon. And then sometimes with a dash of the 55 just to give it more warmth. The 55 is a red. But if you're interested in how I do it and I just color the roots, go and look at that video. For skincare, I used up a Dermatology Retinol Complex 0.5%. This was really nice. What I love the most about it is just the ease of the dispensing. Really nice packaging. They do phenomenal products. I think I have a code. I think it gets you like 20% off or something. So I love their vitamin C, I love their retinol, I love their under eye pads. There's quite a few things from them that I really enjoy. And this was really nice. Like I said, it's really easy when you're in a rush to just pump it out. This is something I got from All Day Chemist, the Indian company where I order my retinol. And I had to, you know, make do to get a bulk of an order. And I put in some of this glycolic acid cream, 6%. This was nice, but it's nothing that I would repurchase. I like stronger things on my face, so would not repurchase. And if you've noticed, I hardly have any supplements in my videos anymore. I don't take many vitamins or supplements now. I have thankfully healed my gut, and I know I need to do a video on that. It was not a quick, easy process. It takes a while. But now that I've healed my gut and I'm feeling so good, I do things very occasionally, like once a quarter. Magnesium I take every day for sleep as well as for your muscles. I also take potassium with this, but I also have the Dr. Berg's magnesium, and then there's another one that's the same ingredients as Dr. Berg's. I get whichever one's cheapest, but they're both the electrolyte powder that I have in a drink, and I love both of those. The only other supplement you'll see regularly is this Kirkland Sleep Aid. I've said many times drug sleep is better than no sleep. I'm still figuring things out. Sometimes I can sleep right through the night. Sometimes I'm awake an hour and a half, and it's always in the middle of the night, no set time. It could be 5 a.m., 2 a.m., 1 a.m., it doesn't matter. It could be Mark snoring, I'm not sure. But I take this, it takes a while, I crunch it in between my teeth to get it dissolving quicker, and then I swallow it, and it gets me back to sleep. I need my sleep, so I'd rather not have to take anything, but if it's a choice between taking something and no sleep, I will take something. You're gonna see that I don't have that many supplements in my empties anymore, yay me! For makeup, I'm gonna count some stuff. Well, this isn't really makeup. Sure, deodorant. Keeps me dry. Would not want to be here in Arizona without this. It is phenomenal. These Crest White strips, I've said before that I cut them in half horizontally and just put it on the front of my teeth. I also usually put them on at night and sleep with them. They never come off. I don't have to worry I'm going to choke on them. I'm totally fine. And I'm using up some of this carbamide peroxide. This is 44%. I showed, and I'll try to remember to link below, the whitening teeth kit. This is amazing. When you use these two together, you get really, like, use this one night, use this the next day, your teeth will be really white. If I could remember to do that every week, I'd have really white, great teeth. My Kiss nails, love them. swear by them. I haven't been to a nail salon now for probably 5 years. It was before COVID that I started on these. Love it. These take 5 minutes. It would take me half an hour to drive to the salon, an hour and a half for them to take them off and put on a new set. 5 minutes. I'm never going back. My Tanned AF, I love this. You just spray it on and with a bronzing mitt, rub it in. I love being tanned. People have asked for my face, how I match it. Usually that's bronzer, and I'll have to demo that at some point. This is my Jergens Natural Glow. I'm using this up along with my hemp cream. It's nice for a moisturizer. This is a better color, easier to use, no streaks, but it doesn't moisturize. So I can find sometimes my skin starts drying out. If I use the Jergens with the hemp, that is so moisturizing. So I might do this every other week or something like that, but this is the one I love for the color. Down to the last few items. I know I owe you a video on my lashes. This strip lash is really, it takes longer to dry. It's thicker, but it sticks on better. I like the one, the Kiss in the, where you pull out the wand and it has the little, you know, the wand, the stick. And you put that onto the lashes. It goes on thinner, but it is not as tight of a glue. So if you have lashes that are not the handmade style, you would use this because with those thicker bands, you need this. If you have the handmade lashes, like I'm wearing now, you can wear the thinner glue that is lighter, it's easier to put on, it dries faster, it's just, it really is more convenient. But I have both in my arsenal depending which lashes I'm going to wear. Speaking of lashes, I do sometimes wear mascara and no lashes, but that's rare. Sometimes I wear mascara and my lashes. That's more common. Sometimes, like today, I didn't even wear mascara. I just put my lashes on, and that's what I usually do. But this Essence Volume, if you want to have a base for your mascara to make your lashes long, this is it. It's amazing. For a while there, I don't know if there was old inventory or what, but they fixed whatever the problem is, and it's now great. This NYX Butter Gloss in Creme Brulee. It's beautiful. I love all their butter glosses. I think, though, I probably won't repurchase. I love my Rimmel glosses, and those are like $2 and something on Amazon. I'll link some of my favorite colors below in the Rimmel gloss. Those are the ones that once I've used everything up or whatever, probably stick with. And then this is a Rimmel Exaggerate. It's the twist-up kind. Love it. Stays on. It's amazing. Rimmel, all of their Rimmel eye products, the Exaggerate, are phenomenal. So that's everything that I have. I'm so happy that I've used up a lip product and an eye product. Some of these are not that quick to use up, so I'm pretty proud of myself. Let me know if you are on a use-up journey, if you find you go through a lot on your empties. We have a great Facebook use-up page, the Makeup Use-Up page, encouraging people to use what they have versus buying, which I love. And it surprises me. Some of the girls say they haven't used up anything so far this year. So let me know where you're at. If you're using things up all the time, I use up a lot because I always wear makeup. But thank you for spending some time with me. I really appreciate it, and I hope you're having an amazing day. We'll talk to you next time.